I drove from upstate New York.
Why?
Well, you tell me why. I want to know why. I want you to make it worth my fucking while. I've been to Richmond, Virginia, Knoxville, Tennessee. I drove all the way down to Atlanta, and then in one burst of fucking energy and idiocy, I drove all the way from Atlanta to Miami. It took me 14 hours. Death stalked the highway in a fucking Graham Black Maserati. Scything down elderly people, women with surprised, permanently surprised expressions and frazzled brownish red hair. We're talking about women in their 70s here. Weird. I see weird things. I love Florida. I think I do anyway. But it scares me to death. I've been to Gainesville before. I came here in 1979. It didn't go well. Tell them people over at the bar to shut the fuck up.
Shut the fuck up!
Stationary on the motorways as well, staring at discarded shoes. I want to carry a card, you know, just like a donor card that says, in the event of an accident, please take my shoes with me. I watched the traffic through yesterday's rain. I watched the neighborhood through distorted panes. I looked at CD artwork through scratchy gray plastic and see pictures of dinners on tins. I've been up, I've been down, I've spent a fortune in pubs and I've bit my nails to the quick. And if I've ever seen such a thing as life in the raw, it was wearing a polyester suit. See, I was brought up on land, school in mundane. We never had fancy when we could have had plain. I was brought up on hard up, school in forget it. We never knew different, we only knew from, though I lied about where I've been. It's not that it's not good enough. It's just that it's no fun, see. Probably like round here and everywhere else. I was brought up on bland, school in mundane. We never had fancy when we could have had plain. I was brought up on harder, school in forget. I wrote this years and years ago. It don't make any sense, but it's from kind of, it's from where I lived, which was the south coast of England. And when I was like 15, I think my ambition would have been to put my hand up a girl's skirt or something like that. It's not something that I'm proud of, you know. As ambitions go, it's not too bad for a 15-year-old kid. And there was a bus shelter where everyone did their courting. I think they did because there were used condoms on the floor. And the windows were all busted and the winds whistled through it and the buses came and went, and you never got anywhere in that fucking bus shelter because we didn't know about the romance. And we watched the ferries going to and from France, which you could see from my bedroom window. It was really a weird place to grow up, but it was quite good. But fuck, I was glad to leave. On a convenient seat by the lavatories in the sodium glare, we used to wait for the bus in a passionate clutch and go as far as we dared. Do you remember when I passed my driving test? I took you to the pictures. Sense. 39 years ago, I think. I've been doing this kind of thing for 40 years, you know.
Yeah!
I'm fucking tired out. Song, you know, and I wanted to write a song that was going to be like the Velvet Underground. It was going to be like Save the Last Dance for Me, and it was going to be like the B-side of The Last Waltz by Engelbert Humperdinck, all rolled into one fantastic 3-minute thing, with a bit of a Cajun thing going on with the French, you know, and I thought, I'll write a song that's got French in it. I couldn't speak French, but I was only, you know, 19 years old. I was headstrong. I didn't think that mattered. I just did it best I could. So the French doesn't mean a fucking thing. Now, my mother at the time, she spoke fluent French. And her friend said, have you heard your son's new record? It's all over the radio station. And she said, yes, I have. But everyone else thought I was very clever. They said, have you heard his new record? It's in French. Wow. Now, I don't know if the BBC were just playing with me and they knew that it wasn't real French, or if they were just as fucking ignorant as I was. But I say, I was ahead of the curve there, because God bless ignorance. Ignorance is blessing. Oh yeah, you know. We didn't have anything like that to worry about. We didn't even have Watergate yet. Civilized, but that was a long time ago. It's more fun here than it was in Tampa last year. Have you ever been to Tampa?
Face
tattoos, you know, anything that will grab the attention. A face tattoo, a snake, a bloody boa constrictor around your neck. I don't want to play to some woman with a face tattoo and a fucking boa constrictor stuck around her neck. I would say, move away, you're depressing me. And all the gays, they're all blonde and they were fucking pouring beer over each other and getting their fucking penises out and comparing sizes. You couldn't see much. It was depressing. I don't like Tampa. Well, I mean, if you think that's great, get along there. They do that thing once a year. It's called Tropical Heatwave. And this guy, he says, I'm from the radio station. It's an honor to have a man of your caliber playing at our festival. I started up and within two fucking songs and a bit of feedback, he was out the fucking door looking horrified. I haven't heard from, I got paid though. I made sure I got paid.
Thank you.
the second floor of number 304 above a handbag store, and the heavy roar of traffic rolling down the Holloway Road. A one-time bedroom as the studio of Joe May. Very country with the sound of another well. The Tin Pan Alley bump was too absurd. The miles of wire and recording tape for fortune, fame, and no escape for Joe May.
Right away.
lose the game. I wouldn't do it different, I'd just do it all again. I'd take my turn, I'd stand in line for Groundhog Day. I'd do it all again for a drive down that fucking long, long road. Someone said to me, my friend, you know Holly Golightly? Yes, some of you do. She says to me, she said, I've never been to Florida. And I thought that was a woman who had played everywhere in the world. But she said, I've heard that all there is there is a long, long road lined with palm trees. And I said, yeah, I've seen the palm trees. I've seen more palm trees at one go than I've ever seen in my whole fucking life. And there's these psychotic drivers. They're all driving around in between the palm trees on the long, long road. I don't know where they're going, but they're all gonna die, and they kind of know they're all gonna die. I don't know, but in between there are these places, you know, for the people who live somewhere behind the palm trees, and that's why I'm here.
But that's old news to most of the world anyway.
be okay. I mean, unless it is. If anyone wants their money back, see the man at the bar. Okay. It's going well.
Better than last time.
It is good.
Were you there last time? Were you even born? I don't even remember it. I sort of do, but I get it mixed up with another weird show in Buffalo in New York, which is up by Canada. Do you know they've still got the global warming up in Canada? I mean, that was a smart thing we did, voting it out, you know? That was good. Because now you can enjoy the super hot weather in February. Well, you get that all the time here anyway, but where we are, a heat wave in February, we all enjoy it now. That's a good thing. But they've got the global warming still in parts of Europe, and I believe in Mexico they've got it, and we're building a wall to keep that global warming out. Only 106 days and we've made so much progress. There's always some musician in the audience and they go, your D is flat, and you can fuck off. I like it like that. This is like a sad tune. It's a sad song in a way, because I sometimes think that I live half my life wasting my life, you know, by not actually living it, just wondering when it was going to start, and then finding out that it was most of the way over. It's like being a kid and running out of school vacation. So, but the tune is jaunty. So, you know, you could say, like, what it lacks in jollity, it makes up for in jaunt, if there is such a word as jaunt. There is good, okay, that's what it is.
Yeah.
I carried a cup. give me a smile. This is just a transitory thing. Here today, gone tomorrow. We'll be outlived by most of these things. By frozen noses and burned out cigarettes, broken fridges, LPs and cassettes, and just about every TV set we've ever owned. Give me a smile. Let's try and walk the extra mile. Come on, girl. And I'm sure that you do too. No one knows how hard it is for someone else just to exist. So it's a slow self-crucifixion. Decades of dark moments and ever-growing bliss. Give me a smile. Come on, give me a smile. Give me a smile, girl. Sing, girl. and a wife for you. And she brought the lips and Tahiti. I go the whole wide world, I go the whole wide world just to find her. Where the Caribbean Sea is blue, weeping in a tropical moonlit night, because nobody's told about you. I go the whole wide world, I go the whole wide world just to find her. I go the whole wide world, go the whole wide world, find out where they hide her. In the rain out here, trying to pick up a gale. Why are my eyes filling up with these lonely tears when this gale's all over the world? Where is she lying on a tropical beach somewhere, underneath the tropical sun? Funny feeling. climb up on the roof, get saturated. I've washed away the trunk and the dirty city rain. Animal behavior on Noah's Ark. Animal behavior on a wooden raft. So every creature, there's no particular reason. I've got this funny feeling.
Semaphore signals down the house.
Thank you. I'm gonna rap the bow deeply. And like in England, it's something that I could get bashed in for, but Tom Petty, I think Tom Petty is really great. So much so that me and my wife recorded one of his songs. And this punk guy in England with a broken nose and tattoos all over his fucking face and metalwork and everything, he said to me, he said, I fucking hate you, you cunt, because you made me like a Tom Petty song. And, like, you know, I found that was the weirdest thing in the world. But fucking hell, it's got to be alright. Has anyone met Bo Diddley? So have I. I used to have one of his guitar picks in my pocket for the longest time, but eventually I got rid of it, I lost it somewhere, but all the Bo Diddley had sort of worn off it, I figured, by then. And I could never play with it because it was as big as my hand, this thing. Sort of sharp pick. But yes, okay. I'd like to talk to you about the miracle of life, because I've learned a lot about the miracle of life by reading the notice boards on the sides of the long road as I've been driving up and down it. And I think I understand what it's all about now. Did you know that 18 seconds after the miracle of life has taken place, which is when the Viagra hardened Donald is inserted into the moist Ivanka, the ladies Ivanka, the miracle of life actually takes place. What actually happens is a fully formed brain of a far-right Christian fundamentalist is actually conceived at that moment. It's fully formed, it needs no adjustments, it needs no learning, it knows everything it needs to know, it knows 20 words of vocabulary, it knows what's right, not necessarily what's wrong, it doesn't know what's wrong, and it thinks it can fix it. It has the brain of the President of the United States of America. And for this reason, this embryo must be protected. It must be protected and not necessarily nurtured. It doesn't need nurturing, just fucking put it in a pickup truck. It is the miracle of life. I don't understand it, but I tell you what, if you ever find yourself in the position of being conceived, just fucking grip the uterus and refuse. Don't come out. It will fuck you up. Once you're born, you are fucked. Stay in the womb. Stay there in the warm and the safety of the womb and let those fuckers look after your embryonic life. Oh, can you imagine the biology of it? Can you fucking imagine the stench of adult diapers and talcum powder? Listerine, talcum powder and adult diapers. That fucking asshole with his fucking toupee hairstyle all over the place, pounding his way into a Russian prostitute. It's fucking the miracle of fucking life. The miracle, the most wondrous thing. Oh shit. It's not just biology, it's wonderful. Everyone's relaxed. tooth than everyone else. And they'll know their ass from a hole in the ground. If you can't find them with both hands or a flashlight, step right in. There may be ground to go around. Call. These colors don't run by sight. Pom pom pom. Thank you.